Okay, everyone, how are you doing? I hope everyone had a good Christmas and New Year's coming up. This is my latest franchise zoo that I'm doing. I'm working set up for the next challenge, which is to breed all the dogs in the zoo. So I've got the zebras, the ostriches, and the warthogs, just to get the money rolling in. And the CCs, because my CCs got low again. Right here I have spotted hyenas, and then here I've got the painted dog. Then right here I've got the dingoes. Then on this side I've got some camels and some Guinness Book bones again for more money and CCs when I release them. Here's my timber wolves. Got them going. Well, I gotta release some of them. And then here's this cool ding that's the Arctic wolf pen that someone developed. This is pretty cool, whoever did this. And then on the last challenge, I had a Himalayan bear prize, so I set up a Himalayan bear exhibit or habitat. Most of what I do is a combination of off the workshop and my own. This piece came off the workshop. This wall I made. These are all basic facilities that I put the aquatic pieces around. I'm not a great builder, but it gets the job done. I made this pen. This pen, which are basically simple. This pen was also made. This came off the workshop. This food court came off the workshop. So did this food court over here. This is a workshop, workshop, workshop. Oh, my hyenas are fighting. Let's see, let's get the mechanic in there to fix the fence. Who's fighting? Oh, the females. Alright. Send you out because I need the money. So, what I'm planning on doing today, and I think it might help some people, I hope, is right over here I'm going to build a gray seal habitat and show how to cover it so that you can get the clear view for the water. Since I have enough money, I can do it now. I use a terrain stamp tool to start it. So I usually shift down a little bit to make it nice and deep. Once I got the initial hole, I go into flattened terrain, and then I go in and expand it. Smooth everything over. The hard part is getting the path down right and the fencing. Once you get that, you're good to go. I like to use the new thing. I usually go about halfway in. See, this is the hard part, is getting this. Once you get that in, you're good to go. So it's usually just back and forth with barrier. There we go. Now we got it. Move those trees. Get out of my way. Move. Stick you guys over here for now. Barrier. That's what I'm looking for. And you just come on around, making sure to give enough room for them to have some land. Whoops. Did I have it? I had it. I had it. Where'd it go? Man, you can adjust it. If it'll let you. I'll come back in and make this a little wider just so I can get the path down in there. Test the water, see that? Look at that. Always test your water level, see that? Means my fence isn't high enough. Why it's not highlighting that direction, I don't know. Clearly we're going to be difficult. Alright. This game, I tell you, sometimes it's good, sometimes it just drives you crazy. So you can see this is barely level with the ground, so I need to make it a little taller. This needs to be taller than the ground so the water doesn't overflow like it did. See, it's still overflowing. See, there it's not. Can I go any higher? Alright. So back to barrier. Make it a little bit taller. You can always adjust later, that's the nice part. You just have to keep playing with it. There we go, now the seals have plenty of water to get into, and look at this so far. See, I'm gonna make this view much clearer by the time I'm done. I hope, that's my goal anyway. Let's fix that, that doesn't need to be as tall as Mount Everest. Because the water's there. Shrink you down too. Down you go. And really, I can probably shrink this down a little bit. Because the other thing that I do once I get the ground in place is once this is covered, I'll have a path down here, an opening right in here, and then I'll have a path going directly over. Whoops. Didn't mean to do that. Now let's see if I can get the path to work. Bigger. Down we go. Water makes it difficult to do anything. So we're going to go back into terrain and I'm going to flatten it out a little bit more. Wrong way. Actually better at flattening out than that. That was terrible. Not working in my favor though. Straight down. Make it a little smaller. Sometimes size makes a difference too, your width of your path. Yep, look at that. Send it that way. Oops, I need to do that. Let's try and do this one. There we go, there's what I was trying to do. So I'll even curve it around like this. Attention to what's going on. Latin. Turn paint. Smooth it looks good. Still not gonna work. Yeah, that's okay, that's good enough. Okay, now, let me show you how to get your viewer. It's going to be super clear. So go back into sculpting, and then you just cover up till it goes slightly inside the barrier. It has to go slightly inside the barrier. And then you just cover up as much as it'll let you. Put the path in the way. And then you just smooth everything out. Oops. It looks really rough right now, but once you put the building on top, it makes a huge difference. Whoops. Didn't want to do that. You need to smooth it out so that you got your view back. Put the water back in to test it. Go down in and check your view. Let's see. Should, if I did it right. Look at that clear view. Look at that. That is how you get a clear view for when you're aquatic animals. And you could do this for any of them. The penguins, the caimans, any of these animals. If you do it like this, you will have the clearest view. Even if you go in here. Look at that. Go inside, and it's not near as clear. And I haven't done anything, no lights or anything down here. Oh, that's interesting. Got kind of a natural formation supports are going on there. That's funny. And then you come down and, whoops, I want this one. Smooth rock. Get rid of all this grass. And then if you want, you come back in here and you can flatten this back out. No, you gotta remove the water to do that. Or you can just smooth it out. Pumps are good. And then terrain paint it however you want. I like to use rock. Since this is a northern animal, there's not going to be a lot of grass anywhere. I think it's mostly rock and, soil and sand. Put the water back in. water feeder, it's deep enough, it's ready to go. So again, you come on this side, and you've got an extremely clear view. I mean, it's even clearer than when you're in the habitat. And then I mentioned that I like to do a path on this side. With the control button. And water. I keep emptying out the water to get the path in. Sometimes I get that it's not even enough. So I'll do this, just one little pop up. And I can't mess with the and connect it on both sides. And then as for this part, I usually go in and put rocks in. Since it's a northern animal, I like to use the ice. I like to use the snow rocks for the penguins, but I'll use these. You can use building pieces, trees, whatever you like. This just simply covers up the ugliness of the roughness. A little bit of a curve there. Make that work. Whoops. Rocks are very even, but that's what's nice about rocks, they don't have to be even. Cover up any thing that doesn't look good to you, or go back into terrain mode. Oops, get all that tall grass. Get it underneath the path over here too. Then we can put the water back in. Hopefully it won't be any issue. Sometimes you add a path, the water gets funny. That should be plenty of room for the... Three seals. I just need a barrier. Gate. Or habitat gate. We'll just connect it to that path. And then we just need to connect this path up. There it goes, getting tricky. There we go. There we go. So there you have it, your basic seal habitat. And then you can go in and... Whoops. Decorate how you like. Since I don't like a lot of foliage, again, I go in and use these tiger tundra rocks. Or I'll use these too. The last one I did, I made kind of a really kind of cool, almost like an obstacle course for them to swim through. See if I can kind of recreate what I did. It was kind of cool. Something like that. And they swam through it. Put these things on top. Rock piles that they made are pretty cool. I like these things. One of my exhibits, I made like it looked like a rock slide. Started with rocks like this. And then just got smaller. And just piled them up. Whoops. Floating rock. Goodness for the undo button. Shift key. Trying to make the rocks look like they're buried in the sediment. Say it. Got tongue tangled there. small rocks. Sometimes putting the line of surface on is a good thing too. Then you can get them in all kinds of different directions, which is, when rocks fall, that's what they do. They're not all uniform in one position, one direction. I even did this kind of rock slide thing right in another zoo I did right near the entrance. And then kind of fenced it off and put a warning sign that said rock slide possible. And that's starting to look funky. Excuse me. Really fun. Got a ton of those. Oh, my blueprints here. I found some skeletons on the. So that one might be too big. There we go. Come on down. I have a skeleton buried in the rock, like the animal that caught in it. That's kind of interesting. Oops. You could do Tioga rocks, that would work. How's that temperate? No one tropical? No, there's Tioga. Oh, wrong size, hold on. There we go. Put some different colored rocks in here. Like the poor whale was just swimming by and got crushed. It's kind of happy for a whale that got crushed, huh? There we go. Come out, whoops, whoa, hang on. You come back out here, look at that. Look at that clear view. Of course, in order to, whoops, keep that view clear, don't forget to add your. Utilities. have the money. No, that's not what I wanted. That's what I wanted. Add a staff room. I guess technically I can move this door over here. Make more sense to put it closer to the keeper's hut. Oops, that path. Don't need that path now. Let's see, habitat, species, gray seal. Just the right spot for that one. Plenty of toys. Getting the food tray right over here. This one, because it's got the lights on it, so it lights up at night. It's really cool. Whoops. Hit the shift key and reset everything. Shelter's not gonna appear. Not up here under here. That's what I was looking for. The seals get sensitive about too much attention. I kind of want to give him some place to hide. Where you can get really creative and go into blueprints. take one. I do apologize. I was going on and on and on. I didn't realize my recording had stopped. Anyway, where I was before I did all that, put all the plants in, was I was building this. I apologize for not getting to see it be built. I commented that I'm a terrible builder. So I don't do things. Keep it pretty simple, see, like that's not even right there. But it still gives the seals a place to hide here, here, and here. And then back here. And then I went in and added plants and added this buried whale skeleton. I'm not sure if that showed up in the other video. Then I finished outfitted the underground viewing area with vending machines, music, trash cans next to the donation bins I found and built with the trash, ATM machine, place to sit, some benches, and then there's an educator stand right here. My scenery rating up to 88%. It was 50%. Added Arctic music. But, I mean, look at this view. This is how you get a very clear view. Alright, so, let me get some seals in here, and then... come on, float up. Gray seals. See if we can find some decent females. That's probably the best one I'm gonna get. I don't wanna spend 2,000 on a male. I just don't want to do it. So I'm just gonna get another female. We'll go with that one. I've only got 2,000 CCs anyway, so I don't wanna spend all my CCs on a male right now. Come on. I don't know if anyone else has that problem where it just takes forever to load. One gray seal. Move in. To the doggy world. That's what I'm calling my zoo, doggy world. So I can start breeding for the next challenge, which I believe starts on Tuesday. I've got some timber wolves in reserve, ready to go. I've got a spotted hyena in reserve. I have some Komodo dragons. I have an African buffalo, which I haven't done anything with. Alright, play. And a couple more rocks to come out. Even that out a little bit. There we go. Speed up the game. Get those seals in there. Coming. Here they come. Here they come! Back to normal speed. There's my seals. Let's check there. Enrichment's good, habitat's good, nutrition's good, welfare's good. Alright. Need more sand. Not. What's that? There we go. Let's check the trees. Ooh, we can even add more. it's only gonna have one plant donor. Thought I had a couple. Nice. Your reputation's up to 4 stars. Nice. Really, look at the seals. Look at them go. So I'll go back down here. So now the seals are in place. We can come in here. Look how clear that is. Look at that seal. Look at him go. Whoops. Come back here. Alright. Not an ideal temperature. We need to cool the water down. And then I need to add some coolers. Because they like it cold. And I don't know why the coolers will not show up when you have the gray seals or the penguins selected. I don't get that. Whoops, since they're northern animals, they like it cold. Oops, no, the place so you can watch it cool off. There we go. Much better. Can't exit out. Cut. And people should be heading over here pretty soon. And check them out. Oh, there we go. We got people down here. Look at that. Putting vending machines and ATM machines down below too also tends to lure guests down because they'll want food and money. Food, drink, and money. We can turn those on. Turn that on. Can't throw water, obviously, or food, I mean. Turn that one on. Boy, that one's not too far away. Need a speaker down here. Yep, perfect. As big as possible. So here they come. Get rid of that for a second. And even it's getting dark too. It's nighttime and look at this view. Even at night, it's clear as can be. I haven't put any lighting in here at all. Just bake out the cover I made for them. A little rock slide. Probably add some more plants though. Look at Now my tickets are underpriced again. America, aquatic, tundra, taiga. Put some colorful plants in here too. We'll get that scenery rating up. Probably going overboard and these seals are going to go into the red, but it doesn't seem to matter so much as long as the... Oops. Some of these to swim around. Let's check the scenery rating. 100%. Sweet. Look at that. This is nighttime. I mean, it's 5:30 a.m. I guess. And look at this. Still have the clearest view with no lights or anything in here except the machines. So there you have it. Ground. Here come some more people. Of course, the seals aren't swimming at the moment. See, come in here and look how dark this is. Where are my seals? Of course one hits the water as soon as I come up. Of course it does. Excuse me. Yeah, see, it went over too far. There we go, perfect. What if that mess with my rating? Nope, it's still 100%. Okay, good. There's my seal, swimming by. So anyway, I hope this tutorial that got cut in half, sorry about that, will help some people in getting a view that's clear as can be. So I hope everyone has a good day and continues to build and practice and get better at their zoo building and their animals. Take care, everyone, and hopefully I'll have a new video out before long. Take care.